So just a quick glance. So planning and optimization unit is responsible for different planning cycles, yearly, monthly and weekly, for a day-to-day business, long-term and strategic decisions. It may include planning optimization, but usually partially for refinery productions or loop blending. Unit could also be responsible for product exchange and term contract economics. So guidance is given on inventory, and I think you can just read through it. I'm just reading it. So responsible for purchase and sales. So with or without hedging to secure wet deals. Okay. So they will also decide whether to take their own production quantity for their usage or to procure it from outside. So they deal with the planning cycles. So depending upon how they plan, whether it's a weekly, monthly, they try to create the nominations. So they do the planning for these barge, rail, truck and pipeline. Okay. And so this team, this scheduling team, you can say. Okay. So this scheduling team is nothing but the supply team, we can say, or schedulers. They act as a bridge between the traders and the transporters. Because until unless they get the inputs from both of them, they will not be able to create the nominations. Okay. So it's a bridge for them. Transportation, again, they negotiate the transportation term contracts. So available transportation units. So they charter the required capacity. So if they do not have their own ships or pipeline capacity or truck capacity, they try to charter it or they try to procure it from outside. Vessel screening, okay. Technical condition, ship safety record, ship crew safety status, environmental issues, if there are anything, that will also be taken care. Similarly, terminal operations team, they handle the loading and discharging of products. Okay. So again, when we talk about terminal, so there will be berth and loading rack scheduling. So a terminal maintenance includes tanks, racks, berths, pipes, gauging systems, and so on. Okay. So they are also responsible for issues and receipts posting, physical inventory measurements. Administration also we talked about, right? Spot contract administration. It can be a legal team or a strategy team who will get involved. So all that. Claim handling, inventory management, all will be taken care of by the administration team. Okay. So when we talk about interaction, okay, so the supply and distribution teams, they interact with many bodies or many partners outside of the system. That means, for example, planning and optimization team, what they do whenever they have to plan something, obviously the pricing is important for them. Okay, so they take the inputs of the pricing. Similarly, when they have to do some calculations with respect to that, they also have to follow some guidelines that are set up by the International Energy Agency or legal teams or tax teams, etc. Similarly, they also get some inputs from the global regional head office in order to plan. So how much is the capacity? How much is the optimization that they want to achieve? What kind of products they want to blend in order to get the right value? So that also, again, they cannot take on their own. They cannot decide on their own. So obviously they need the information again from this refinery production team. Okay. Similarly, they'll also need some information from the fuel marketing team. So like this, so these people, they try to deal with different parties, like from external parties as well as the internal parties. So these are the internal teams or internal parties, whereas these are the external partners. So they always get the information from these partners, then try to analyze. Similarly, when it is a trading team, so trading team, they deal with either a broker, okay. So they also deal with the vessel owners because the product movement, for the product movement. Similarly, supplier vendor, okay. Similarly, customer also, they try to deal with. Okay, so then, so trading again, here they have to be very careful about the taxation part. So then they deal with the tax team, finance team, okay. And refinery production teams also they interact with. So like that, depending upon the kind of roles they have, they might be interacting with the different partners here. So if it is a transportation team, so they deal with the operators. Okay, they deal with the different teams. Again, within the company, they might deal with the traders. They will deal with the transportation. The terminal operations teams, because whatever they decide on the operators, that information has to be shared to the terminals, because these people will have to manage the berths, tanks, all that. So like that, these people interact with the different partners, and these partners are all set up in SAP. So some, I mean not all, so most of the cases, so this is publication, so this publications we get it for the pricing. Okay, and vessels, if you're a vessel owner, that means if he's a shipping company, we consider it as a vendor. Similarly, if we are buying some raw material from outside, for example, like yesterday we discussed about BPCL, HPCL, IOCL buying from ONGC or Oil India. So we will set them up in the system as vendors. Similarly, if ONGC is buying, or for example, if BPCL is buying its products to its customers, some commercial customers like fertilizers, okay, then fertilizer company will be a customer to BPCL. For example, NAFTA is used in fertilizers for fertilizers. Okay, similarly, whatever the plastic products you have in your day-to-day life, Vaseline, petroleum jelly, they are all byproducts. Somewhere or the other, there will be some components which you will get from the oil and gas byproducts. Okay, so depending upon the scenario, depending upon the kind of activity that these people do, like planning, planners, traders, schedulers, dispatchers, operators, or administrators, they deal with the different teams